going to talk about another token-based mutual exclusion algorithm called Rayman tree-based algorithm, right? So in the earlier class, we discussed about Suzuki Kasami algorithm, and I illustrated with an example how that algorithm works. So this is the time to see how actually Rayman tree-based algorithm works. So there are some few general points about Rayman tree-based algorithm and its logic. The first point is the Rayman tree-based algorithm is a token-based, as I said already. Here, there is a special practice used. One, that is, the sites involved in a distributed systems are logically arranged as a directed tree. So there is a tree data structure used here, right? Such that the edges of the tree are having directions towards the root that is having token. Initially, the root node is said to be having token holding node. I'll be showing how actually this arrangement is being done in the next slide. But you have to keep in mind the sites are logically arranged as a directed tree. Okay. And every site has a local variable. Every site, that is every node, we can say every node of the tree. Now, each and every single site is becoming a node of the tree, yeah? So every node has a local variable called holder. This variable is called as holder variable, right? Holder variable H of the site is SI, which points to an immediate neighbor on the directed path. So A and this node is B, then the holder of B will equal to A and solano, because the holder variable holds the pointer to the immediate neighbor in the upward direction. In other way, every node holder variable is meant to represent its parent. HA evana varukum self nu irukum, right? Because it does, the A is the root here, so its holder variable value will be self. It is pointing to itself, okay? And then every site keeps a FIFO queue, first come first out queue, called request queue, right? So every site, if a holder irukka madriye, there will be a request queue, RQB, right? It's a queue, it's a FIFO queue, right? Which stores the request sent by neighboring site, right? So then you have to remember, so there are, one thing is, the data structure here used is a tree, directed tree, and a holder variable is used, and another data structure, which is a queue used, right? Okay, let's come to the algorithm. To demonstrate you the example, then we will come to the algorithm, then you can able to understand it well. Okay, so let's take this example. This is a directed tree. Okay, for our simplicity, I have referred every site as A, B, C, D respectively, right? This is A is site 1, and this is site 2, and this is site 3, likewise, okay? So every, now you look at, this is a directed tree. Here, 7 sites. Right, 7 sites, okay. Now, you look at here, D is directed to B, B is directed to A. So, B is the parent of D. At the same time, B is again the parent of E. We can say B, D, E all neighboring nodes. Similarly, B and A are neighboring, right? But direction is towards A. Then, madri F is directed here, having a directed edge to C. G is having a directed edge to C. And C in turn having a directed edge to A. Now look at here, this is a blue color circle indicates the token. According to our initial condition, initial state, the token will be holded by the root node, right? Now What will be the data structures? How actually the node, I already mentioned, every node is having two things. One is request queue, another one is holder variable. Now see how, what are all the holder variables. For the node D, which is a whose parent is B, because there is a directed edge from D to B. So H of D, that is holder of D, will be equal to B. And what will be the request queue? Initially, there is no request from any site to any other site. So the request queue is empty. Similarly, for E, the holder variable is B, because E is also connected to B. And its request queue is also empty. Similarly, here, the holder variable for B is A, because B's parent is A. And its queue is empty now. Similarly, F node, HF, holder F is C, and its queue also empty. Holder of G is equal to C, and also the request is empty. Holder of C is equal to A, and its request is empty. Now, holder of A, because it is a root node, its holder value will be self. Initially, there is no request, we are assuming, so that all the request queues are empty. Now, we are exploring the scenario. Send request for token. Since D wants to enter into critical section, now D sends a request message. There are two messages possible. One is the request. Another one is privilege. There are two messages. Request message is the message issued for token, requesting token. Privilege is granting token. Now, D will send a request message to its immediate neighbor. Because D is having a directed edge to B. So B is the immediate parent or neighbor. Okay, it sends a request message. Now what happens to the data structure? The data structures has to be, there is a holder variable and the request queue, both should be updated. The holder variable is not going to be changed because since then, what about the request queue? The changing variable only is indicated in blue color. The request queue of D becomes D. It will be D. Then the request is, when the request is received by node B, the node B request queue also will be changed, okay? Because there is a request from D. So in the request queue, D entered. Then what happens? On receiving the request from the child node D, B enna pannu next stage. But now on receiving the request from D, B will forward the request to A. Received the request message, right? Forwarded request message. Okay. Now what will happen to A? In the changes, a request to A, which is a holding node, token holding node. Next, what happens? Node A, which is holding the token, will send the privilege message. Receiving the request from B will check whether A is in its critical section. If so, it will wait till it completes the critical section and then send the privilege message. Otherwise, if the A is not in critical section, it is free holding the token now, immediate privilege kudutru. Right? So once privilege is granted to the requesting node B, the request queue becomes sorry, holding edge becomes change. Holding, right? Okay. So what is that holding node? Since the direction of the arrow gets changed, direction of the tree is that edge is changed. Now A is folded by B. Yeah. So H of A is equal to B. Then the holder variable value is changed to B because A is now pointing to B. Okay. And since the request is privileged, now the queue should be deleted. Okay. Appa top entry la B irundirukum illaya, idha delete pannikom. So now the queue become empty. Next, what happens? Since the privilege is granted to B and A's folder variable is changed to B, now B becomes the root mari aayiduchu ipo the token inga vandirukum, so that the holder value of B also changed to self because nothing request. Yeah, okay, matha node alla appadi irukum. Now what happens? Token comes to, token is privileged to B. Next, once it comes, B now forward the token to D. When it privileging token to D, then it sets its request queue empty because it deletes the top entry D. Okay, so only popping up the topmost value available in the request queue, that is the address where actually the target message to be forwarded or token to be forwarded. Here, look at here, B's holder variable also changed because the arrow direction married. So B is folded holding D. Okay, so HB equal to D comes here. Token is granted to D. So now there is no outgoing edge from D. So this becomes self. The holder is self. And D also on receiving the token, D also deleting its queue entry, top of the queue, so that queue becomes empty. Right? So the other will be as usual in the change maker. The algorithm first, as usual in every algorithm, there are three sections. One is requesting critical section, another is executing critical section, and finally, when exiting the critical section, what to be done? Okay. On requesting the critical section, when a site want to enter into critical section, it requests for token. It D wants to enter into critical section. By the time what it does, it sends the request message to its immediate parent. Once after sending the request, immediately that sending site is updating its request queue. Yeah. Then when the parent, that is the immediate neighbor node, which receives the request message, it also update the request queue, okay, by the value from which node it receive the request, and forward the request message to its own parent, because when the request message is received, the site will check whether it is holding the token. If so, it will take care of privileging, or otherwise it forwarded to the immediate neighbor. That is what its parent. Okay. In this case, the end of the point, this directed request forwarding continues till the root is reached. In the request message, root node sends the token to the site from which the request is received. Right? So how actually it sends the token? With the privilege message, and it sets its holder value to the requesting site. Once the token is passed on or privileged, then immediately arrow direction changed, yeah, so that the holder value will be set to the requesting site. Right? When a site receives the token, the requesting node received the token, then it deletes the top entry from the request queue, that I told you, no? And sends the token to the indicator site, it sets its holder variable to point to the target site. Okay, B and the fifth point and fourth points. Okay. Coming to the execution. When the site enters into CS, when it received the token and its own entry is at the top of the request queue, then delete the top entry from its own request and enter into critical section. Otherwise, not executing critical section. Once after finishing the critical section, the critical section should be released, illaya? Okay? Adha release pannumbodhu, if the request queue is non-empty, then deletes the top entry from the queue and sends the token to that site and sets the holder value to the target node. Other sites or further request comes. The holding, token holding site can enter into critical section at any number of times. N number of times until there is a further request. Right. Now come to here. When there is a token is initially assumed to be at the root node. Now all the holder variable, corresponding holder variables and queues are empty. Holder variables are correspondingly mentioned. Now D wants token, want to enter into critical section. So it sends a request message to B. Okay, and change its request queue also. On receiving the request message from D, site B also changed its request queue and all other nodes and the changes may irukka adana adala onnu pannala po, right? But now B will forward the same request message to A because A token is with A, right? So on receiving the request, A also changed its request queue with because H A is holding B, appa B oda holder variable maaranum to self ne, because there is no outgoing edge from B, adu self node, self indicate, self loop la irukum, sorry, self pointed a irukum, and then the token is actually requested by D. B will transfer the token to B by deleting its request queue, make it empty, and the token now goes to the D. Now token is held up by D. D can hold the token. Once after, it can go and execute critical section, right? And when come back to the critical section, when come back from critical section, enna pannum the token, D was in critical section. E made a request. E made a request. So a request from E will be forwarded by to B, right? To D. Appo the request queue of D here equal to E, D is equal to E. R queue of B equal to E, but R queue of D equal to B. Now when the D node completes its critical section and come back to the normal state and check its request queue. Now the request queue is having B, not empty, illaya? Appa enna pannum, the token inga privilege pannidum, right? So appadi privilege pannichina, token comes to B. Right? Appo here HD equal to again B. HB equal to self. And now the request queue will be deleted. B will forward the token to E by again inga privilege aayidum. In the node ipo delete aayidu. Right, so now the token is granted to E. Now H E equal to self. So now E can go and enter into critical section because the token is issued. Right, so this is what happened when actually the node exiting from the critical section. If suppose the node on exiting the critical section, if D finds the still the queue is empty now, அப்ப நோ ஃபர்தர் ரிக்வஸ்ட் பை அகைன் வாண்ட் டு கெட் இன் டு கிரிட்டிக்கல் செக்ஷனா திருப்பி போய் அதை இந்த மாதிரி ரிக்வஸ்ட்லாம் எதுவுமே தேவையில்லை பிகாஸ் டி இஸ் ஹோல்டிங் த டோக்கன் ஓகே ஆஸ் மெனி டைம் ஆஸ் டி வாண்ட்ஸ் டு என்டர் இன் டு கிரிட்டிக்கல் செக்ஷன் இட் வில் என்டர் டில் தேர் இஸ் அ ரிக்வஸ்ட் ஃப்ரம் எனி அதர் சைட் ஓகே ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் ஹவ் ஆக்சுவலி ரேமண்ட் ட்ரீ பேஸ்ட் அல்காரிதம் ஒர்க்ஸ்